For over half a century, Sonoma County residents have relied on the Russian River for a clean, reliable, and affordable drinking water. Fish and other wildlife also rely on the river, which is why, in 2008, the Sonoma County Water Agency was required by a federal biological opinion and a state consistency determination to change our water supply system to help protect local endangered salmon and threatened steelhead. The Sonoma County Water Agency has worked tirelessly to create a new, modernized system for managing our most precious resource, the Russian River. One of the required changes is to reduce minimum summertime flows, which are set by state regulation, in the Russian River and Dry Creek. Reducing minimum flows will benefit juvenile steelhead and coho salmon by slowing the speed of the water in habitats these young salmon use to feed, rest, and grow. Chinook salmon would benefit from the conservation of cold water during the summer in Lake Mendocino for release during their fall migration and spawning season. Lower summertime flows also means that when the mouth of the river closes, the water levels in the estuary rise more slowly. This slower rise would allow for more beneficial habitat for young steelhead to be preserved in the estuary before they head out to sea.
Lake Mendocino and Lake Sonoma fill up and store water during the rainy season. The water agency then releases that water when we need it during the dry season.
The amount of water released is different for dry, critically dry, and normal years. The problem is the measurement tool we are required to use to determine if a year is dry, critical, or normal,
called the Hydrologic Index, is outdated. The Hydrologic Index, created by a state regulatory decision over 30 years ago, is based on inflows into PG&E's Lake Pillsbury, which is located in a different watershed.
Over the past decade, the amount of water from Lake Pillsbury that PG&E diverts through its Potter Valley project and into the Russian River watershed has been reduced by 60%.
As a result of these reductions, the Hydrologic Index is no longer an accurate tool for measuring hydrologic conditions in the Russian River watershed.
This is why the Sonoma County Water Agency is proposing a new hydrologic index that will be recalculated monthly based on the total amount of water that has flowed into and stored in Lake Mendocino in the Russian River watershed.
We are also proposing to change the current three water year types, normal, dry, and critical, with a more precise bi-schedule system,
with one being the wettest condition and five being the driest and most critical. These new measurement tools will better reflect Russian River watershed conditions and allow us to adjust to dry or wet conditions more quickly than under the existing index. For example, if there is no rainfall in February, typically one of the wettest months,
the new hydrologic index would allow the water agency to conserve water in the reservoirs by reducing releases rather than waiting till the end of the rainy season, allowing for a more reliable water supply for Lake Mendocino.
There are several gauges along the Russian River that measure the level of the water as well as the amount of water that is flowing past the gauge. We measure flow in cubic feet per second, or CFS. One cubic foot is about the size of a basketball, so when we talk about 100 CFS, we are saying that 100 basketballs of water are passing this point each second. How much water we release from Lake Mendocino and Lake Sonoma is based on estimates of the river's natural flow from creeks and streams, how much water our customers need, other communities and farmers' needs, the amount of water that gets used by trees and plants along the river, and the amount of water that needs to be left in the river, its minimum flow. Minimum flow levels in the watershed are measured in the upper Russian River above Healdsburg, in the lower Russian River below Healdsburg, and in Dry Creek. The Fish Flow Project proposes to change the minimum stream flow requirement in the upper Russian River to 105 cubic feet per second in the wettest years. In Dry Creek, between May 1st and October 15th, the minimum flow will be 50 CFS. The lower river minimum will be 70 CFS between May 1st and October 15th. In the driest years, minimum flows in the upper river will be 25 CFS, in Dry Creek, 50 CFS, and in the lower river, 35 CFS. It is important to remember that the minimum state-required in-stream flows in the Russian River and Dry Creek are minimums. Often, the natural flow from runoff and tributary streams results in stream flows that are higher than the minimum required. Water supply releases from Coyote Valley Dam and Warm Springs Dam, which account for approximately 15% of the watershed, are made with a buffer or extra amount of water above the minimum required to ensure that stream flows are maintained for downstream uses.
An important part of the proposed project is updating the Water Agency's water rights permits. As part of the project, the agency will ask the state to extend the timeline out to the year 2040, the timeline to utilize the agency's existing water rights of up to 75,000 acre-feet per year. Thanks to people conserving water, the Water Agency has withdrawn an application that was filed with the state years ago requesting an increase in the total amount of water right per year. A recent planning report found that by continuing good conservation practices, Water Agency customers may not need more than 75,000 acre-feet per year until 2040. People throughout the Russian River watershed care deeply about the river and may be eager to learn about the potential impacts of this project. If you have questions about the proposed project or the draft environmental impact report, we hope you will speak with Water Agency staff during the workshop. We welcome your written comments and participation in the upcoming public hearing. There'll be no formal presentations at the workshop, and no verbal testimony will be taken, but there will be forms available for written comments. A formal public hearing will be held on Tuesday, September 13th, at the Sonoma County Board of Supervisors Chambers at 575 Administration Drive in Santa Rosa. Written comments can be submitted to the Sonoma County Water Agency, Attention Jessica Martini Lamb, 404 Aviation Boulevard, Santa Rosa, California, 95403. Comments can also be submitted electronically via a link on our website. The Water Agency will respond to comments in the final EIR.